स्टार्ट सेकेंड चैप्टर माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स फ्रेंड्स एंड फो. वी हैड इट्स इंट्रोडक्शन एंड लर्न अबाउट बैक्टीरिया इट्स वेरियस टाइप्स ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ शेप एंड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ देयर ऑक्सीजन रिक्वायरमेंट. मूविंग फर्दर टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट रेस्ट ऑफ द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स. शैल वी बिगिन? यस. नेक्स्ट इज वायरस. वायरस द टर्म हैज बीन डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम अ लैटिन वर्ड विच मीन्स पॉइजनस लिक्विड्स. वायरसेस आर स्मॉलेस्ट माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म दैट कैन बी सीन ओनली विद द हेल्प ऑफ एन इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप. दे आर असेलुलर. व्हाट डज इट मीन असेलुलर? A plus cellular. That means it is devoid of basic cell structure. It is not having any particular cellular substances in it. A small nuclear material wrapped in a protein coat combines together to form a virus. Sometimes viruses are considered to be a connecting link between living and non-living. Why? Because they cannot reproduce, they cannot grow on their own. They require a host body to do their life activities. If we go for the examples of viruses, we have a long list of viruses. For example, influenza virus, polio virus, coronavirus, HIV virus, etc. Now, the next microorganism that we have to study is algae. Algae is a Latin word which means sea weeds. Weeds you have learnt in chapter 1. Unwanted plants, right? Now, what are algae? Algae are a group of plants actually, but they do not have stem, roots, and leaves like other normal plants we are used to see in our neighborhood. They have chlorophyll and are autotrophs. For example, Chlamydomonas, Spirogyra, Volvox, etc. The next microorganism that we have to learn is fungi. Fungi is actually a microorganism without chlorophyll. It have saprophytic mode of nutrition as well as parasitic mode of nutrition. What is saprophytic mode of nutrition? Yes, recall, you have learnt about it in your class 7th. Yes, very good. Saprophytic mode of nutrition is the mode of nutrition in which the organism derives its nutrients from dead and decaying plants and animals. What is parasitic mode of nutrition? Parasitic mode of nutrition is the mode of nutrition in which an organism live on other living organism for getting its requirements for nutrients. Fungi generally grow in dark, warm and moist conditions. You must have seen some bread getting some green blackish patches on them if they are not used within the expiry time period. That is fungus, bread mold, scientifically known as rhizopus, R-H-I-Z-O-P-U-S. You must have done this activity in your lower classes, right? And these fungi can be unicellular, they can also be multicellular. We have several kinds of fungi. Some are edible and non-poisonous, but some may be poisonous. Can you suggest me any edible fungi? Yes, it is mushroom. How many of you love to eat mushrooms? Yeah, of course, many. Mushroom is actually a fungi that is Agaricus campestris. It is its scientific name, Agaricus, Agaricus. Campestris, Campestris. I'll give you the details later on in PDF format. Don't worry. So what other fungi can we state for their example? They can be yeast, they can be mold, mucor, penicillium. Okay. The last but not the least microorganism. It is protozoa. Protozoa actually means first animal. It is unicellular and its mode of nutrition can be either saprophytic or parasitic. We have an exception of Euglena in it. Euglena contains chlorophyll and shows autotrophic mode of nutrition. Other examples of protozoa are amoeba, paramecium, trypanosoma, etc. Are you confident enough that you have learnt something about microorganisms now? Stay tuned for the next video.